Okay, this is part two, and right down here is the basic formula that's being used, and we see the basic formula expresses what I just described. So I've got in this formula three variables. The first one, J, stands for the stage. So I have stage 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Those are the different values of J. The next variable is this Z, which stands for a node. And in particular, I'm computing the min over a bunch of nodes, which are in the subsequent stage. So this reads J plus 1. C of SZ, well, S is a node, and C of SZ is the cost to go from node S to node Z. Now, S is a node in the current stage, in the stage J. So if I'm in J equals 3, then S can be any one of these three, E, F, or G. And Z is a node in the subsequent stage, so then Z can be H or I. So C is the cost from the chosen node S to the destination node in the next stage, Z. So the cost from E to I would be 4. F of J plus 1 of F sub J plus 1 of Z. Z is the node in the subsequent stage. And I'm computing here, this is what's already been computed in the previous step. This is the cost at stage J from 1, the optimal cost that I've discovered from stage J plus 1, to go from node Z in that stage to the destination. So in the case of E, for example, well, in the case of H, for example, the optimal cost to go from H to the destination node would be 3, okay? So at each stage, I'm computing for every node in that stage, I'm finding the optimum path to go from that node to the final destination. And the way I'm doing that is by finding the minimum cost to go to each of the nodes in the subsequent stage, and then adding the already computed optimal cost to go from that node in the subsequent stage to the destination, which is what that is.